Hello, welcome back. This is a bit of an impromptu video. I'm just piecing it together quite quickly because I've been recently been getting a lot of questions about a certain scheme that's come out called Forsage. So today I'm making this video for two reasons. Number one is to talk about Forsage and the underlying technology that they're using and what the business does. And then number two is to talk about why it's the absolute worst thing to happen to crypto in 2020. So let's get started. Firstly, let's talk about Forsage. So it's the latest get-rich-quick MLM scheme that sort of reached the industry at the moment, both the crypto industry and the wider community, specifically in my network in Southeast Asia. And it uses blockchain tech and smart contracts to meet its ends. So what are those ends? Well, with any pyramid scheme, and this is a pyramid scheme, the idea is to get the majority of the money from the bigger chunk of the pyramid and funnel it to the top, which is pretty much what it does. Now, I guess you could say from an ethical standpoint, the one thing I do like about this project is they don't lie about it, about what it is and about how it works. So, I mean, I'll give it that. However, if you're getting involved in something like this, and I'll talk about this a little while later, you've really got to question yourself about whether you get involved. And then if you do get involved, whether it's a good idea to get your friends and family involved. And that's where the ethical question comes in. So basically, how it works is they cast a really wide net to try to get as many people to contribute 0.05 ETH, like I said, about 10 to 15 US dollars, which is then filtered through many layers. And then basically the majority or a significant proportion ends up at the top of the pyramid. And that's basically how it works. So it gives the most benefit to those at the top, done by the work at the bottom. Now, what work is that? It's simply just marketing and recruiting. There's no underlying product. There's no underlying service. They're not even pretending to invest your money, and that's where the distributions come from. Every dollar that somebody earns in the Forsage network is being paid by someone in the pyramid below them. And then the only way that that next layer gets money is by then onward selling to more people. So it's pretty straightforward. It's not like you're investing in a product or there's some kind of service or a business that's actually going to grow and do something and sell something to the service. All you're doing is selling more people to get involved in the Ponzi, which is then further funding the Ponzi. So then we have a look at, why am I calling this a Ponzi, right? Like, so there's three main things that we need to look at when we're talking about what a Ponzi is. Now, so a Ponzi scheme is a fraudulent investment scam promising high rates of return to little or no risk to investors. Tick, we've pretty much got that signed off. That's pretty much what they're offering people. I mean, I will be honest, the risk to someone who is starting just with the 15 bucks, that isn't essentially a very low risk sort of opportunity. And that's why so many people are being drawn to it. And I think that's why they're being so popular, because if I can invest 15 bucks and then in a month I'm gonna get 3,000, it's sort of like, why the hell wouldn't I try it? Why not? Second, the Ponzi generates returns for early investors by acquiring new investors. Tick, this is the entire way up the pyramid. The only way for you to earn decent money in this scheme is by recruiting more people. And guess where the returns that you're getting come from? The contributions of those people. Tick. Thirdly, new investors' funds are used to pay earlier backers. Tick. Pretty much they're the main points of how this program works. So because there's no underlying product, service, utility, and there's nothing being produced by this scheme, like they're not taking the ETH and then, going and investing it somewhere or investing it in something and then it's then generating a return for the investors. It's just user money being cycled up through this funnel. Think of it like a water filter in reverse, where granularly bits are being taken out and cycled through the network, but most of the money is being pushed up the top. Pretty much a pyramid scheme, pretty much a Ponzi. Look, I mean, it's. I wouldn't say it's an outright scam because they're honest about what they're doing. Like they've basically come out, and the CEO actually came out and said he's been in MLMs for 20 odd years and he just wanted to create an MLM that got rid of all those pesky products and got rid of the Amway style stuff and just dealt with the money and was basically like, yep, you recruit more people, you get money. But you've got to understand, there's a real ethical problem with that. Essentially, you're just getting more and more people to invest their money, which then filters up and up. There's no production, which means that the vast majority of people will earn nothing and lose their $15. It's only $15, but I'll be honest, in some parts of the world where I've been working, $15 can actually be a lot of money to some people. And I think that it's immoral to basically be trying to get people to put their money into something that is an obvious Ponzi. And the way that you as an individual are getting paid by recruiting more people is to get them to, yeah, contribute money to the Ponzi when you know there's no underlying product, service, or productivity being done by the network. It's actually a really, really, from a moral standpoint, it's actually quite a difficult thing to overcome for myself. That's why I wouldn't get involved. So how it works is person one contributes 0.05 Ethereum. That then is distributed to the person's upline as being, you know, part of the fact that they've been recruited. Then I then go out as person B, and then I'll then have to go out and recruit up to five people. And there's, I'm not going to get into the whole scheme, but there's five slots that are open. And then I convince five people to go and invest in my five slots. And then they'll give some F. I'll get two licks of that. So out of the five, I'll get, you know, 0.05 times two. So I'll get 0.1 of an F. I've doubled my money, happy days. Then that then layer of people then has to go do the same thing again. What does it look like? A pyramid. Why are they called pyramid schemes? I wonder. And so the only way that money is generated for me is by people at my direct recruits or lower, going in and bringing more money in. The issue is that people are shilling this stuff to their family, friends, and their network. So there are people making money in this scheme, and there are ways to make money in this scheme. Now, number one, the founders and the guys who started the program would be making an absolute killing right now, no question. Number two is if you're a fairly large influencer and you've got a large support base of followers who'll get into whatever the hell you're selling them, that's number two, which is why you see a significant amount of affiliate marketing people getting involved in this. I have not seen a single competent cryptocurrency or blockchain expert person getting involved in this scheme. It's all affiliate marketing, get rich quick bullshit. And that's exactly who it is. And you try to see, I've seen the explanations that people have done on smart contracts, and it's like pretty much verbatim off what they've read off the company's website. So you're not seeing like the actual guys who've, say, been in crypto a couple of years, seen all the scams in 2017, come back and go, oh no, I was wrong about all that other stuff. This thing's the way to go. I haven't really seen it. And most of the stuff I've seen online is affiliate marketers who, that's what they do. They shill other people's products and get a commission. So something like this is ideal for someone like that. So these guys have big followings and are able to market to a large group of people. And then that's how they're able to beat up their teams. The other way is third, and I'll explain this later, they've bought their way up. So after we've gone through initial explanation, so let's say you've got your five slots and you've run out of slots, you can actually pay more money to then upgrade the amount of slots you have, so you can then recruit more people and you get a bigger earn when you do that. Where that money goes, where that upgrade money goes, and I think the biggest upgrade is like 20th or something like that. I'm not 100% sure. I mean, at the end of the day, I can tell you right now, with only looking at this thing for a short period of time, and I've been in financial services for a long time, that this thing is a Ponzi. Now, so I'm not sure if those upgrade funds goes up to your upline or whether it goes directly up to the company for those upgrades, and that's how they're making their money. Not too sure. However, I will say that at no point in the process of people giving money and entering into the smart contract and all these things being generated is a single dollar of value being made by the business. The only thing the business has done is set up a smart contract, built a website, and pushed this stuff out to a bunch of affiliate marketers. That's literally what they've done. That's their value add to the world. I know that sounds ironic because obviously a lot of crypto projects have not exactly done the best by the world, but I'm not saying that's excusable, and this definitely isn't either. But that's essentially all they've done. That's the only value that's been created by this product, is a website and a smart contract. For the actual end user, no benefit, other than the fact that it gives you an opportunity to earn money off your friends and family by getting them into a Ponzi. However, I would honestly be saying, if you're interested in getting into a program like this and you want to sort of make money off your friends and family, get a t-shirt, screen printed t-shirt with your face on it, sell it for a $10 to $15 profit, and at least your friends and family are going to get something out of their money. they're going to get a shirt with your face on it. I mean, that is a better investment of their money than getting involved in something like this, to be absolutely honest. So, on top of that, the Philippines government have recently outlawed this scheme. I think there's about a 5 million peso, which is about $100,000 fine, and up to 21 years imprisonment. Now, this might be seen as being a bit extreme, but regulators do not ever put massive action on a scheme unless it's seen to be harmful. Like, they don't just do this stuff for fun. I mean, it did take regulators something like 8 months to get on top of BitConnect. And we all saw how that ended, and it took, you know, they would investigate them and they'd say, look, you've got to provide all these things within the next few months or we're shutting you down. And that was all in late 2017. And then it still took 3 or 4 months before the whole program blew up.
What?
So the fact that these warning signs are already showing themselves, people should be a bit more cautious, especially because the regulator has outlawed it and fined people for shilling it in their own country. I've never seen that. So why is this the worst thing to happen to crypto in 2020? Other than the issue with the MLM and the Ponzi and all that kind of stuff, my gas fees are absolutely ridiculous for Ethereum transactions. Operating on a decentralized exchange, trying to do a transfer, anywhere between, you know, $2-3, sometimes higher. $3-4 I'm talking about as a transaction, whereas previously this transaction only cost 10 cents, maybe less. It's greatly increased the gas fees at the moment because there's so much traffic on the network because of this thing. This is CryptoKitties level crazy.
We are belting the entire world!
That it is, I think it's second to USDT in the amount of transactions being done through this smart contract. And that's greatly slowing up the network. The other issue is that this is going to be the first experience that a lot of people have in crypto. And I think it's great that people are going out and they're learning how to buy Ethereum on an exchange and then they're transferring it to a trust wallet or a MetaMask or whatever. I think it's really good that these things are happening. However, if the first experience of somebody being in crypto is to get into a Ponzi and get burnt, even if the dollar figure is quite small, it can actually degrade the industry as a whole. I think that even though it is an opportunity to make money for people, it's not going to be the best thing long-term for the industry. So the lesson here is basically, if you're thinking about getting involved in Forsage, understand that number one, you are getting involved in a Ponzi. I mean, that's without question. Can you make money? Yes. But then you've got to look at yourself in the mirror every day, understanding that you've got your mum, dad, sister, brother, friends, colleagues at work, all these kind of things. You've got all these people that you've knowingly got into a Ponzi and they may not get anything out of it. So I've heard stories of people making money out of it, great, but I think that the steps morally that you need to get through to get there, I mean, is it really worth it? Like, there are better ways to make money. And remember that back in the day, I mean, with BitConnect, obviously everyone's heard of BitConnect. These kind of things were happening. You saw people on YouTube shilling this thing, saying it's, oh, you know, I've made 15% in a month, blah, blah, you know, the returns that BitConnect were offering were 465% a year. This is actually claiming even bigger returns than BitConnect, to be honest.
Let me tell you guys that I started 137 days ago with only $25,610. And right now I am reaching $140,000. Whoa, what's up?
And you had all these people trying to explain away the criticism of the scheme. Oh, well, it works like this, blah, 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 blah. And then these articles are still there today with people defending BitConnect, where they've said, oh, look, it's not a scam. It works by, you know, staking and you're getting these returns here and la, la, la. But the whole thing, obviously, it was a Ponzi. People called it out, people defended it, but then it was always a Ponzi. Now, very few times in human history has a Ponzi been called out and people have been like, this thing is a Ponzi or a pyramid scheme or an element and have been incorrect at a scale like this. There's not been any business that a government has said, nah, if you promote this, you're going to jail or you're going to get fined $100,000. When it has been a legitimate business, it just doesn't happen. So read the signs and really think about what you're getting involved in. And lastly, and I'm just going to put this again. Look, I don't mean any offense to anybody who has gotten involved in the program, But I really think you should have a look, like from a business perspective, and really understand what you're getting involved in. Now, how many businesses around the world that have been profitable and successful over the years have made money from literally doing nothing? You're essentially grabbing money from a lower tier of a pyramid, pushing it up a level, then some of that money goes up another level and up another level and up another level. There's no product, no service, no nothing. It's a website and a smart contract, and you're getting fooled by it. Thank you so much for spending a bit of time with me today. I'm sorry if that was a bit harsh, but I think there's no other way to tackle a problem like this. I've got another few primer videos coming up, which I mentioned in my last video. I'll get those out this week. Thank you again for stopping by. If you like what I'm doing, please hit like, hit subscribe, all those fun things, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.